Hey friends, in this video we are going to discuss some amazing tricks of Microsoft Excel. The first trick that we are going to discuss is that how we can remove extra spaces from our data. Here you can see we have data in which we have multiple extra spaces. So how we can remove extra spaces? For this we need to use trim function. We will use trim function equal sign. We will write trim. Open parenthesis, we will select cell from which we want to remove extra spaces, close parenthesis, enter, and you can see we have been removed extra spaces from this cell. And now we have only one space between words. So we will drag it down and we have been instantly removed all extra spaces from our data. The next trick that we are going to discuss is that how we can repeat any text or number multiple times. Let's say for these numbers we want to repeat 10 times each number. How we can repeat? We will use REPT, that is repeat function. Open parenthesis, what we want to repeat? We want to repeat this number or value in the cell. Insert comma. Next thing, number of times. How many number of times we want to repeat? Let's say we want to repeat 10 times. We will insert 10, close parenthesis, enter. And you can see this number 1 is repeated here 10 times. So we will drag it down and here we go. We have been repeated each of these numbers 10 times. The next trick that we are going to discuss is that how we can automatically change font color based on status of an invoice. Here we have list of supplied invoices that we need to pay to our suppliers. Here we have due date for each of these invoices. Then here we have status for these invoices. Let's say we want to keep font color as blue if invoice is not due yet. Let's say we want to change font color into black if invoice is due today. And we want to change font color into red if invoice has been due many days ago. How we can do this? To learn this, first of all, I will delete everything whatever we have in these cells. Then we will use simple formula to know that what is difference between due date and today's date to know status of an invoice, that it is due or is not due yet. So what we will do, equal sign due date minus, we will use here today function. Today function will give us today's date. We will insert, we will press enter and answer is minus 6. Actually today's date is 7 October 2021. So 1st October minus 7 October, answer is minus 6, meaning this invoice has been due 6 days ago. We will simply drag it down. As today's date is 7 October, so therefore here answer is 0, meaning this invoice is due today for this 17, meaning this invoice will be due after 17 days, and so on for all these invoices. Now to change font color according to status of any invoice, what we will do, we will simply select all these cells in which we want to change color. We will use shortcut key Ctrl plus 1 to open format cells window. We will go to custom. In custom, we will delete whatever we have here. We will simply delete. What we will insert, we will insert square bracket. We will write blue, again a square bracket close, 0, semicolon, square bracket. We will write here red, square bracket close, square bracket close, 0. Actually we need to insert here semicolon between blue and red, again semicolon, square bracket open, black, square bracket close. Now this first bracket, the color will be for positive numbers. As we said, we want to do positive number, positive, for positive numbers we want to do color blue. So in first square bracket we write here blue, for second red, that will be color of negative numbers, and black will be color of 0. Now we also want to add here, let's say for 17 we want to add here days left, meaning 17 days left. For any negative number we want to add overdue days or days overdue. So what we will do, we will insert here quotation mark. For positive numbers we need to add days left, days left, quotation mark. For negative numbers we will, after 0 we will insert here quotation mark and we will write days overdue, days overdue, quotation mark. Again for black, because black color will be for 0, for 0 we don't need to write number of days, we will simply write here due today. So what we will do, we will write here, insert here quotation mark, we will write due space today, again quotation mark, we will go for OK, and here we go. You can see actually we need to insert space also. We will again go to same window, and here we will insert space before days, here space before days, and this is simply okay, and here we go. 6 days our due, 5 days our due, this is due today, 17 days left, 7 days left, and so on. Next trick that we are going to discuss is that how we can separate text and number from our data. You can see here we have text and numbers in one cell. In each cell we have text as well as we have numbers. In first cell you can see first of all we have text, then at last we have number, and here we have first we have number, then at last we have text. So how we can separate text and numbers from our data? Simply what we will do, for let's say for first cell we will simply write here text, whatever we have text in this we will write here. Here we have text David, so I have been written here text David. For second cell we have Leonardo text in this cell, so I will write here Leonardo, enter, and for remaining cells I will simply use shortcut key for flash fill Control plus E, and here we go. You can see from all these cells we have been separated text from all these cells. For to separate numbers, same thing we will do from first cell and second cell, we will simply write numbers 2598643. As in this cell we have this number 2598643, we have been written here. For second we will write 756823, enter, and for remaining cells we don't need to do anything, we will simply use Control plus E, and here we have been separated numbers from these cells instantly. The next trick that we are going to discuss is that how we can instantly delete all blank columns from our data. We know that whenever we export our data from any application or from any software, it gives us a lot of blank columns. So how we can instantly delete all blank columns? For this, first of all we need to select our complete data. So what we will do, we will simply for the first active cell we will select first active cell, and I will use shortcut key Control Shift and End, and this will select our data till end. Then what we need to do next, we need to use shortcut key Control plus G, it will open go to window. We need to go to special, in special we need to select here blanks, we will go for OK, and it will select all blank columns. Now we need to use shortcut key Control plus minus, it will give us delete window as we want to delete all columns. So what we will do, we will go to entire column, we will go for OK, and here we go. You can see all blank columns have been deleted instantly. Next trick that we are going to discuss is that how we can sum and average our data from multiple sheets. Let's say here we have results of sales for Jan, Feb and March of our sales team, and we want to sum up all these three sheets into this one summary sheet. We want to create summary of sales from Jan till March. How we can do this? Let's say we want to know for David. For this we will simply use here equal sign and sum function. Let's say we want to do sum sales of David for Jan, Feb and March. So we will write here sum function, open parenthesis. We will simply go to the first sheet from where we want to start. As we want to start from January, we will go to the Jan sheet, and here we will select cell that we want to sum up. Then what we need to do, we need to simply hold shift key, and then we will go to the last sheet. We will, you can see Jan, Feb and March, these three sheets we want to sum up. March is last sheet, we hold shift key and we will simply click on March sheet, close parenthesis, enter, and here we go. By doing this we have been summed up sales summary of David in from Jan, Feb and March sheet. We will simply drag it down, and now we have summary of sales done by each salesperson in Jan, Feb and March sheets. Now for commission, let's say we want to do average of commission for Jan, Feb and March. We want to do average of commission for all these salespersons. So for this time we want to do average equal sign. We will write here average function, open parenthesis. Again, we will go to the first sheet from where we want to start. We will select cell that we want to do average. Hold shift key, simply click on last sheet where we want to end, close parenthesis, enter, and here we go. This is average of commission of debit in Jan, Feb, and March. We will simply drag it down, and here we go. Now for commission, we can simply multiply sales multiply by commission, or the other way that we have done already, we can simply use equal sign, sum function, open parenthesis. We will go to the first sheet, select cell that we want to sum up, hold shift key, click on last sheet, close parenthesis, enter, and here we go. We can simply drag it down, and here we have sum up commission of all the salesperson from Jan till March. We can cross check, simply let's say for David equal sign, we can go to Jan, we can select commission of David in Jan, plus we can go to the Feb sheet, we can select commission of David in Feb, plus we can go to the March sheet. In March sheet, we can again select commission of David, and we can press enter, and here you can see this is by simple method commission of David in Jan, Feb, and March, and you can see there is no difference, the both figures are same. The next trick that we are going to discuss is that how we can sort our data from left to right. We know that we can sort our data from top to bottom, but how we can sort our data from left to right? Let's say here we have month names, and we want to sort this from left to right. How we can do that? For this, we simply need to select cells that we want to sort from left to right. We need to go to data tab. In data tab, we need to go to sort option. In sort option, we will click, and this will give us a sort window. We need to go to options. In options, we need to select here. Do we want to sort from top to bottom or left to right? As we want to sort from left to right, we will go for OK. And here we need to select. Do we want to sort from A to Z, Z to A, or in any other order? Let's say we want to sort from A to Z, we will go for OK. And here you can see April, August, December, and at last we have September. Let's say we want to sort properly as per month names. Again, we need to select, go data tab, sort, in sort window, go to options, left to right, and here we need to select custom list, and here we will select this list that is month names. We will go for OK, and here we go. You can see Jan, Feb, March till December. Let's say same we want to do for numbers. We will select all these cells. We will go to data tab. We will go to sort option. In sort window, again we need to select, do we want to sort top to bottom or left to right? As we want to sort left to right, we will go for OK. And here we need to check what is row number. As this is row number 9, already we have here row number 9. As we have been selected this row, now how we want to sort? We want to sort cell color, font color, or cells values. As here we have cell values, we don't have cell color, and how we want to sort? Let's say we want to sort largest to smallest. We want to bring here largest value and here smallest value. So go OK, and here largest value 4500 and here smallest value 121. So in this way we can also sort our data from left to right. So friends, if you like this tutorial, please don't forget to give thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel Microsoft Office Tutorials, and also don't forget to share this knowledge with your friends. Thanks for watching. See you in next video. Bye bye.